everyone. I'm Dr. Z. I'm a clinical psychologist specializing in transgender care. Welcome to my channel. Let's talk today about hyperfeminization, hypermasculization, over-masculization, over-feminization. Those are those things that we tend to engage in when we are transitioning or still continue to engage in even post-transition. And I want to tell you what they are. Most of you already know what that is. And I want to explain to you why that might not be the best way to go as you're transitioning, at least not for everyone. So initially when we start transitioning, it is natural and only normal for a lot of transbinary individuals, especially, to desire to really present and to desire to really get as close as possible to their goal. And for a lot of transbinaries, the goal will be opposite gender of what they're assigned gender at birth. That's just how it is for most transbinary individuals at least. Now for non-binary people, it's going to be different. For transbinary, the goal will be the opposite gender. And as a result, people tend to really, really focus on what that opposite gender is externally supposed to be represented. The problem with that is that we fall into chasing stereotypical gender markers. For transmasculine guys, for example, that may look like over-obsessing with certain aspects of what society perceives masculine, over-obsessing with finding the right stent to pee device, over-obsessing with a need to get phalloplasty, or obsessing with going to gym and really building up body mass, body muscle, over-obsessing with when you get top surgery, when you get mastectomy, or obsessing with making sure there is no scars or the scars are very minimal, so that way nobody can tell that you had top surgery. So it's over-obsession with all of this stereotypically gender-specific, what we in society call male body, and trying to get your body as close to that male body as possible. For trans women or trans feminine women, for example, that usually manifests as over-obsessing with getting large breast implants or obsessing with body feminization to the point where you really want to have that very strong, curvy figure, or obsessing with facial feminization surgery, or obsessing with particular style of clothing, or obsessing with hyper-femininity where you think that femininity equals a woman with makeup, a woman who is all dressed up, a woman that has her nails done, etc., etc., etc. So we're talking about this hyper-feminine and hyper-masculine attributes that people tend to chase as they transition. Now, of course, it's understandable, right? After all, you don't feel comfortable, nor do you identify with the gender assigned at birth. And being transbinary, you strongly identify and you strongly connect to the opposite gender. So it would be very natural for all of you to want to get yourself as close physically as possible to the way you perceive yourself, to your true self, right? So it's normal that you will also look at societal clues and societal markers as a way to guide and navigate your transition. All of this is completely normal, and most of us do it, especially those for whom passability is a huge, huge goal to achieve. The problem when we over-masculinize, over-feminize, hyper-feminize, hyper-masculinize, is by chasing that ideal, we in many ways trade one dysphoria for another type. So in many cases, people will end up trading gender dysphoria only to find themselves having a very extreme body dysmorphia, because now you're so obsessed with hyper-feminizing and hyper-masculinizing your body that nothing is just good enough. So that's another trade-off, right? Another trade-off is trading gender dysphoria for social dysphoria. And that is where, because you're so in many ways fixated on achieving the ideal, as the result, you start, for at least not for everybody, but for some people, social dysphoria starts to manifest. Meaning every time you go and you don't get that external validation or external approval, that will spike up internal dysphoria, internal sense of incongruency. And all of those things are not helpful, nor are they healthy. To be very clear, it is, like I said, it's naturally normal to have a goal of passability. It's natural for people to want to get themselves as close to the ideal man or woman that they see within their mind. What's not healthy is when we detach that goal from our innate internal understanding of who we are as trans male or trans women. What I mean by that is that we also have internal schematic representations of gender. You may not be aware of this, but you already have internal schematic representation of yourself in regards to particular gender identity. It may be still deeply unconscious. It may be not still made conscious and hasn't been brought up to the surface. So you may not be really aware about it, but it's there. It's internal there. It's the same schema that has been pulling on you all of your years and telling you that you don't really identify, nor do you feel comfortable with the gender you were assigned at birth. The same schema also has an internal representation of how you see yourself as a woman, how you see yourself as a man, also how you see yourself as non-binary, if any of non-binary individuals are watching this video. The internal schema is made up of your own association to what femininity and masculinity is. So in chasing the ideal, you are negating and you are disregarding your internal self. Let me clarify even more. So I'll use myself as an example, okay? So I'm cisgendered and I feel very comfortable in my gender and I feel very comfortable in my femininity. My internal schema of my femininity is a femininity that is the way that I see myself internally as a woman, is a woman that is professional looking, well put together, a woman that looks well. I also have a schematic representation of myself as a woman who doesn't really like any kind of surgical interventions, plastic surgical interventions, to interfere with the natural process of aging. So the woman inside of me wants to age naturally. A woman inside of me likes the lines and the wrinkles and everything else that we get acquired with age, which to me tells a story of our face and tells a story of who we are. So that's my internal representation, a part of my internal representation, not all of it, but part of my internal representation of who I am as a woman. Now, I live in Los Angeles, in California, and Los Angeles, at least I live very close on the outskirts, very close to Beverly Hills, which is somewhat known to have a lot of individuals and a lot of women who do enjoy plastic surgical intervention as they age, who do enjoy in preserving the usefulness of their face, preserving the usefulness of their skin. And that's totally fine, right? Everybody has to find what works for them. I would be negating and disregarding my internal schema of who I am as a woman if I became so obsessed in trying to fit in with the microculture of Los Angeles where I live. If I were became so obsessed with trying to fit into this club of some individuals who genuinely enjoy getting plastic surgery and suddenly started getting plastic surgery when that does not fit my internal schema. Do you see what I'm saying? The same thing for trans individuals. You have internal schema of yourself as a trans female or trans man. Your internal schema might be a woman that is very casual, that is not hyper feminine, that is really likes to have smaller breasts, likes to have more narrow physique. For trans men, your internal schema might be a trans man who is not overly masculine. It could be somebody that has chest scars because you're proud of what you've been through. You're proud that you undergone and went through gender dysphoria and that you made it. All of those things could be your internal schema. And it's also in relationship to gender as well. So to then suddenly trying to fit in the stereotypes or some of the clustered microcultures out there would be really being untrue to yourself. Again, it's very similar to me suddenly shifting my internal view of myself as somebody who likes naturally to age to suddenly go under knife. Not that there's anything wrong with going under knife, but this is just not my philosophy. Everybody will have our philosophy. So you have your own internal philosophy that informs your inner femininity, that informs your inner masculinity, your own internal philosophies that create that schema of who you are in relationship to your gender. And it's your job to figure out what that internal philosophy is. It's your job to discover who that internal woman or internal man is. What does that person looks like without being bombarded with external or masculization or feminization? Trying to really find out and sit with yourself what makes you comfortable. After all, like I said in some other videos, you don't really want to be an assembly line, right? You don't want to be just like everybody else. Everybody else sticking to assembly line of what it is to be a man, what it is to be a woman, what it is to be a woman in LA, what it is to be a woman in New York, what it is to be a man in Kentucky, what it is to be a man in Florida, etc., etc., etc. You want to find out what it is to be you, first and foremost. Then what it is to be you in relationship to your gender. What is your internal schema? How does that relate to your world? How does it relate to the way you want to externalize it? How does it relate to the way you want to be seen to other people? And that's why it's really important. Now, of course, if your goal is to achieve that over-masculization and over-feminization, and that's truly your internal schema, by all means, go for it. Absolutely. Always be true to yourself. But what I see is I see a lot of people getting very, very obsessed, borderline to the point of where it's starting to cause them a lot of distress, starting to cause them this feeling of I'm unworthy of being a man, I'm unworthy of being a woman, because I can never achieve the curvy figure, I can never achieve having, having a penis, I can never achieve having this, I can never achieve having that. Well, you know, people, we're human beings, are all incomplete one way or another. Nobody's ever so 100% perfect. We all have things that happen to us. We all have things that shape us up, and nobody's really fully complete. The idea of being fully complete is really how you see yourself. It's really an internal viewpoint of yourself within yourself, not so much an external viewpoint. So be very mindful when you start transitioning. And as you go through transition, part of it is this internal process. Part of it is to figure out what is your internal feminine schema is or masculine schema is, because trust me, you have it. I see this over and over again, that people actually do have internal schematic representation of who they are in relationship to their true gender, even though they haven't had a chance to live their life in their true gender. Now, there's a lot of ways you can get in touch with that. One of the ways that I find very helpful is for people to create a Pinterest board or some kind of collage or something. Because a lot of times, if you were to look at the images and to look at the pictures, because unconscious does communicate to us in images, you will naturally gravitate toward particular aspects. That's just natural. That's just our innate self communicating to us what we tend to like, what tends to appeal to us. Same way, if I were to live through a magazine today, for example, I were to just naturally gravitate toward certain things that already make up my internal schema. I may not live it yet, but it will be there. So, you know, start paying attention. What kind of things you tend to lean for? Why do you tend to lean for? Don't just try to fit into the stereotypical mold of, again, masculinity and femininity in today's society. Find your own mold. Create your own mold that's only true to you. And make sure to remember that the mold is ever changing, right? It's not set in stone. So your idea of yourself will grow and will change as you evolve as a human being, because nothing is static. Let me know below and comment below. Have you engaged in, as you're transitioning or transitioned in this over-feminization, over-hyper-masculization, chasing this ideal that is out there, byproduct of our culture? What happened? Are you happy? Have you achieved that ideal? Did it bring you happiness? Did it leave you empty? What really transpired for you? Or were you somebody who realizes that you need to find that inner schematic representation of yourself? And how do you go about finding and getting in touch with that inner schema? So let me know, comment below, and I'll talk to you guys all next time. Bye.